Oh, I wish you could change the green light to some any other color. Could that be possible? That to like blue or yellow, anything. Oh, that's so much better. Thank you. It was just really putting me off. Okay, thanks. Bob, you ever been to CBGB? He was standing next to me at an NYU dorm mixer. That's New York University. Students in flared denim danced the hustle to Fly Robin Fly, the hairpins on the boys' yarmulkes catching the light from a disco ball. He puffed nervously on a Marlboro, and his voice reminded me a little of Ratso Rizzo, the Dustin Hoffman character from Midnight Cowboy. You ever been to CBGB? I shook my head, no. He was my height, skinny, with dark frizzy hair and light olive skin. He wore a plain red t-shirt and black jeans. Black jeans, I said, where do you get them? I'd never conversed with a real New Yorker before and couldn't think what else to say. I also really, really wanted to know where to find those jeans. I noticed the boy had acne scars, just like me. He saw me looking at his cheeks. You try tetracycline, he asked. Everything, I said, and sighed. He nodded. Finally, somebody who understood. The DJ put on Good Times by Chic. Oh, I love this record, he said, twitching his shoulders to the beat. I was pleased he wasn't one of those death to disco types. Why did you have to choose one type of music over another? I moved my shoulders too, then my hips, and then we were dancing. I looked into his brown eyes, darker than any brown I'd ever seen. By the time the record ended, I was in love. Bob. He was from Long Island, exotically, thrillingly Jewish. He chain smoked, took Valium, loved Lou Reed, even when he hated him. A suburban version of my Harriet the Spy New York City fantasies, Bob was an only child who'd been coming into Manhattan to see shows since he was 13. He'd seen The Who, The Kinks, The New York Dolls at Club 82. He'd ridden the Cyclone roller coaster at Coney Island on acid. He talked about Hunter and Wagner, the guitarists in Lou Reed's band, as if they were close family members he had a problem with but still cared for deeply. He grew moist-eyed over Fluffy Kittens or Brian Eno, was adamant that the only egg creams worth drinking came from Gem's Spa on 2nd Avenue. He'd quote Captain Beefheart in my ear, Webcore, Webcore, as if all the wisdom of the universe was contained in that word. Everything he said was an education.